Happy New Year's, everyone. With this year coming to a close, we felt it was time to sit back and take a look at some of the awesome games that popped up in the world of Unity. Keep in mind, there's no particular order of these titles that we've gathered, and if we've missed a game that you love from Unity this year, post it in the comments. I'm Ryan with GameDevHQ, and if you're new to our channel and looking to sharpen your game development skills, insight to level design, or news on the development world, then drop us a subscribe for a new video every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Beat Saber is the first title on our list. It's a VR game by indie game studio Beat Games. Players pick up the motion controls of their preferred VR gear and slash away at waves of incoming blocks with their energy blades and moving to avoid incoming walls. The blocks and walls come at you in perfect sync with the selected song, and your slashing away at them adds the perfect harmony of notes. The game features several songs that have about 4 or 5 different levels of difficulty, and as the blocks head towards you, they are color-coded to indicate which saber that you need to hit the block with, as well as a directional arrow to determine where you need to cut the block across. Number 2 is an open-world survival adventure called Subnautica by Unknown Worlds Entertainment. You're put into the shoes of the sole survivor on a crashed ship on a planet known as 4546B. It's here you will fight against nutrition, hydration, oxygen on a daily basis to stay alive and expect various unseen life forms to intervene and mistake you as food or opposition. The game has an awesome storyline that you'll follow between surviving the planet's dangers, and you'll learn to build the tools, bases, submersibles, as well interact with the wildlife. You can play in standard survival mode, or if you prefer something more, you can jump into the hardcore mode where death is actually permanent. If you need something light, then you can backtrack and use the creative mode to build bases with all the blueprints unlocked and no resource consumption. There's also, of course, a freedom mode, which is the same as survival, but without the hunger, nutrition, and hydration system, making the options for playing Subnautica pretty flexible. The game is primarily set underwater, with the exception of 2 explorable islands. It also supports VR headsets as well, so you can hop in and take a look and get a real immersive underwater experience. A third title today is an adventure RPG called Pillars of Eternity 2 Deadfire, developed by Obsidian Entertainment. The title is a sequel to, of course, Pillars of Eternity, and it features an isometric perspective that you'll use to manage a party of adventurers across the world of Eora. You play the role of the Watcher. He has the ability to look into the souls of others and read their memories. You'll have to choose from 7 different companions to party up with on your adventure and determine which classes and abilities they'll have. You'll build up a personal relationship with your party as your story unfolds and work together through intense strategic combat. If you manage to survive, you'll travel the world on your very own ship, which you'll upgrade over time and choose its own skill set to better your party during your exploration. The game has complete freedom to go where you please and choose on your own time how to proceed, where to explore, who to help, and who to take down in this classic D&D style gameplay. Number 4 is Ghost of a Tale, is an action RPG that's crowdfunded on Indiegogo, where it was primarily developed by an experienced developers from DreamWorks and Universal Pictures. You'll play as Tilo, a smallmouth minstrel who uses stealth, cunning, and wit to traverse through the dungeons and dangerous lands while uncovering the past. Run into fellow critters such as mice, rats, frogs, crabs, badgers, hawks, spiders, leeches, and yeah, even magpies. The game offers beautiful animations, amazing puzzles, and powerful stealth systems to escape the grasp of bigger foes that you gear up to and take them on in various methods of combat. Tilo begins his adventure centuries after a cataclysmic event known as the War of the Green Flame. A mysterious ball of emerald fire destroys the world and creates an undead army who now walks to Earth in addition to the various other obstacles Tilo will face. Our halfway point with game number 5, Chessaria, a tactical RPG developed by Pixel Wizards that follows the same rulings you'd expect in a chess game with a twist. Play as 3 possible races in this hybrid RPG chess game, High Elves, Dark Elves, or Orcs. Each has 6 heroes based on moves and attacks from traditional chess pieces. The goal of the game is based on levels that include rescue operations, zone dominations, assassination bounties, and of course, boss battles. Chessaria can be played in three game modes: Adventure, Quick Game, and Online Multiplayer. The Adventure mode is of course a solo campaign with hundreds of puzzles and battles using the chess system. Quick Games can be PvP or PvE modes and allow customizable games like Classic Chess or other chess variants. Fae is an action-adventure platformer developed by Zoink and is our number 6 on our list. The player controls a little fox-type creature in a vibrant abstract forest. You'll defend this forest with your life from the Silent Ones and get helps from other creatures around the world. You'll go through, guide these creatures, and complete tasks, solve puzzles, and learn new abilities. The entire forest is responsive to a unique language that is all in song, so there isn't actually any words in the game. So you sing to the other creatures to gain their help. And this way, you will exchange knowledge and learn new songs for new abilities and actions to request from other creatures. As a player, you'll have to experiment quite a bit, as there is minimal instructions on what to do, but this allows you to freely explore the world and enjoy the setting to the fullest with the ever-changing ecosystem. Number 7 is Overcooked 2. This is a cooperative cooking sim where a team of up to 4 players will work together to prepare dishes in ridiculous restaurants. Chop, cook, and combine ingredients to serve the combination on a conveyor belt to reach the consumer. The game is built directly to overwhelm you as you move about and bump into other people who are all dressed up in their own costumes and are punished just as much by moving platforms and interactive levels that make cooking even more difficult as time goes by. This game is awesome for playing together at home, making a great addition to the party game genre. Number 8.
You finally arrived.
Dusk is an awesome throwback to retro FPS games. Published by New Blood Interactive, the game takes place in a rural town known by the game's name, Dusk. Under the little town is a massive network of ruins that are discovered, which attracts attention of government concern, and they try to actually harness the magic discovered under the city. Your goal is to reach the exit of each level while surviving all the dangers on the way, such as demons, ghouls, undead, sentient scarecrows, and all kinds of crazy, devious monsters. You'll pick up a vast area of weapons like dual-wield sickles, pistols, double-barrel shotguns, and even a mortar for those who really love watching things blow to pieces. There's also a multiplayer component to the game, which supports up to 16 players in a deathmatch scenario. It follows a lot of the design patterns you'd expect from games like Doom and other old-school FPS. The ninth game on our list is Unruly Heroes by Magic Design Studios. This action-adventure platform takes characters from the Chinese legends of the Monkey King. It features both solo and co-op mode, so you and your friends can work together through this perilous adventure with beautiful art, animations, and sound, and hope to recover the sacred scroll and restore peace to the land. The game boasts a massive foray of traditional animation on top of modern techniques, creating a unique visual display as you solve various puzzles and defeat memorable enemies. The final game on our list, Return of the Oberdin. This is a puzzle game developed by 3909 LLC. In this puzzle game, you're on an East India Company ghost ship where your crew has all mysteriously died along with his passengers. Your objective, of course, is to discover how. As an agent of the shipping company, you'll use a combination of reasoning and what is called the momentum mortem, which is a stopwatch that lets you return to the moment of a crew member's death. This will help you determine the identities and add to the clues that you find amongst the ship. This mystery puzzle game features a crazy one-bit monochromatic graphic theme inspired by early Macintosh systems. It makes for a pleasant retro experience with head-scratching problem solving.
Here, let me help you.
This concludes our top 10 Unity titles in 2018. If there's a title that we missed and you really want us to take a look at it, as well with the new year right around the corner, what are your goals as a developer? Let us know in the comments, and before we go, we'd like to thank all of our subscribers at GameDevHQ.com. It's because of members like you, we're able to continue putting out content 3 times a week, as well build awesome courses to help further your passion for game development. A special direct thank you to some recent new members, E3 Unity Dev, OJ Zach, and Quint721. Thank you guys for your continued support, and thank you to each member of GameDevHQ. If there's something that you guys want to see us do or teach, come join us on Discord and let us know. The link, of course, is in the description, and that's all for today. So again, Happy New Year, and we'll see you guys later.